Before we get to today's homework, let us see how we can make delta debugging faster. We must realize that delta debugging is a rather dumb algorithm, where dumb means it's rather economical in terms of assumptions. It assumes nothing about the input structure, it requires little, but on the other hand, it gets the job done. The interesting thing is that the more knowledge about the structure of the input you put into delta debugging, the more efficient delta debugging becomes. Let me illustrate this by an example. When faced with this 20-character input, delta debugging will have to split this into two halves in the beginning. But since delta debugging doesn't know about the structure, the division will be right in the middle of the input. If delta debugging knew, however, that the input was HTML, then it may come up with a split that would occur at the boundaries between HTML tokens and actual text. Something like this, for example. And if you repeat this, now for the first substring, you will see that we will be able to simplify the input much faster, because now our simplification follows the structure of the input. Let me illustrate this with our example. Here again, we have delta debugging as is, and we're applying it on this very input, as we just saw. When I press on run, we can now see the individual runs, and in the end, one character after one character is being removed, until we finally see, after 29 tests and one assertion, we see the final result, the simplified input select. How can we make delta debugging aware of the input structure? We have already seen that delta debugging works on lists as well as on character strings. So what we could do is, we could split the string into individual substrings according to the input structure and have delta debugging work on that list of elements instead. This is such a list of elements. First, we have the select tag, then foo, and then the end of select. Now what we have to do is, we have to adjust our test function such that it will merge the individual parts of the list back again into a string, which we do up here. We're using the Python join function, which takes all the elements in a list and concatenates them with the first string as separator, in our case, an empty string. So the effect of this is that all the elements that are in S right now will be merged together. And then, in the reconstructed entire string, again, we search for the select tag. In our initial setting, it took us 30 tests until we minimized the input. So, on characters, we have seen it took ddmin 29 tests, again excluding the assertion, to simplify the input. How many tests will it take on a list of tokens that is on this list of tokens? And here a token is a substring with a decisive meaning. You can try this out for yourself or just estimate. Is this 4 tests? Is this 6 tests? Is that 12 tests? Or is that 29 tests? Over to you.